My brother Kiko once had a very peculiar chicken. It was peculiar because no one could tell whether it was a rooster or a hen. My brother claimed it a rooster, I claimed it a hen. We almost got whipped because we argued too much. The whole question began early one morning. Kiko and I were driving the chickens from the cornfield. Suddenly, we heard the rapid flapping of wings. We turned in the direction of the sound and saw two chickens fighting in the far end of the field. Look at that rooster fight. If I had a rooster like that, I could get rich in the cockpits. Let's go and catch it, I suggested. No, you stay here. I will go and catch it, Kiko said. My brother slowly approached the battling chickens. When he got near them, he dived and caught one of them. I ran over where he was and took a good look at the chicken. Why, it is a hen, I said. What is the matter with you? Is the head making you sick? My brother asked. No, look at its face. It has no cob or wattles. No cob and wattles. Who cares about its cob or wattles? Didn't you see it in fight? Sure, I saw it in a fight, but I still say it is a hen. The argument went on the whole morning, until on our way home. When we arrived at our house, Kiko tied the chicken to a pig. The chickens flapped its wings and then crowed. There, did you hear that? My brother exclaimed triumphantly. I suppose you are going to tell me now that hens crow and that carabas fly. I don't care if it crows or not. I said that a chicken is a hen. We went into the house and the discussion continued during lunch. It is a rooster. It is a hen. Now, my mother interrupted. How many times must father tell you boys not to argue during lunch? What is the argument about this time? We told mother and she said, went out look at the chicken. That chicken, she said, is a binabay. It is a rooster that looks like a hen. That should have ended up the argument. But father also went out to see the chicken and he said it is not a rooster. What makes you say that that is a hen? Have you ever seen a hen with feathers like that? Mother asked. Listen, I have handled fighting cocks since I was a boy. And you cannot tell me that the thing is a rooster. Before Kiko and I realized what had happened, father and mother were arguing about the chickens by themselves. Soon, mother was crying. I know who can settle this question. My mother said that Teniente del Barrio, chief of the village. So we took the chickens to the chief. Is this a male or female chicken? Kiko asked. It does not look like any rooster or any hen I have ever seen. No, that could not be a chicken. I have never seen like that. It must be a bird of some other continente, said. Oh, what's the use? Kiko said, and we walk away. Let's go to the town and see Mr. Cruz, who had studied poultry raising in the University of the Philippines. He would know, my brother said. But like that Teniente del Barrio, Mr. Cruz was not able to recognize it. We walked back to the barrio, Kiko said, sell it most of the way. Then he said, I know how I can prove to you that this is a rooster. Would you agree that this is a rooster if I make it fight in the cockpit and it wins? If this hen of yours can beat a gamecock, I will believe anything I said. So that Sunday, we took the chickens to the cockpit. Kiko picked a red rooster open. I suppose to match the chicken against the red rooster because it's a killer. It has killed more chickens than the fox. But my brother did not listen. Too much was made and the birds were ready for the killing sharp. Steel jabs were tied to their left legs. Everyone wanted to beat on the red game cock. I expected our chicken to die of fright. Instead, a strange thing happened. A lovesick expression came into the red rooster's eyes. Then it did that love dance. It was all our chicken needed. It rushed at the red rooster and in one lung, it buried its spurs into its opening chest. The fight was over. Toip, toip. Fix fight, the crowd shouted. Then a riot broke out. My brother and I had to leave through the back way. I had the chickens under my arm. We ran toward the coconut grove and kept running till we lost the mob. As soon as we were saved, my brother said, "Do you believe it is a rooster now?" "Yes," I answered. I was glad the whole argument was over. Just then the chicken began to quiver. It stood up in my arms and cocked with laughter. Something warm and round dropped into my hand. It was an egg.